This is George Price, and we're in Anderson, Indiana, at the Anderson Public Library, and we're Mr. Irving Kelm, is that correct?
Kelman, yes, Irving Kelman.
Okay. Tell us about your visit today.
We are from the Traces Center for History and Culture. We're a small World War II history museum based in St. Paul, Minnesota. We're made up of 26 exhibits, and I'm with a museum on wheels. That's one of our exhibits, and it's about the 370,000 Germans who were captured in Europe and North Africa during World War II, 1943 to 1946, and then brought here to the States. There were 660 camps all over the U.S., 220 in the upper Midwest, and 10 of them here in Indiana.
No kidding. We're out in Indiana.
Camp Atterbury was a base camp. It held several thousand men. And then there was camp in Elwood, Madison County, Windfall in Tipton County, Austin, Vincennes, Indianapolis, Chesterfield.
No kidding. In Chesterfield, Indiana. Chesterfield, of course, and Elwood's real close to Anderson right here.
Oh, okay. The Elwood camp was just temporary. It was for 6 weeks in the summer of 43. The other camps lasted in 44 and 45. And it was decided to bring the men here ultimately because all our men were gone fighting the war, over 10 million men. There was a labor shortage. So the War Department decided, let's bring the POWs here. You put an ocean between them and the war, so if they try to escape, they essentially have no place to go, and we needed the labor. And wherever work needed to be done, they'd set up a camp, bring the men out, and set them to work.
No kidding. Well, I guess it's a piece of history a lot of folks don't know about World War II and about Indiana.
Yes, it's not in any of our textbooks, so unless you had POWs working on your farm or you were in a town that had POWs, you pretty much don't know.
Okay. Well, how often do you make it to this part of Indiana, sir?
Once a year. We go out twice a year, once in the fall to the west Midwest, north and south Dakota, Kansas, Nebraska, and then in the spring we head east, Wisconsin, Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, and Michigan.
Traces. Folks want to find out more about Traces. How can they do that?
Traces.org, T-R-A-C-E-S, Traces.org. We have a website. You can see all 26 exhibits, and you can see where the bus is going and where the buses have been.
All right. Well, it looks like you've had a continuous line of traffic all day. We appreciate you taking the time to talk to us.
My pleasure. Thank you for your interest and for coming out here. I appreciate that, too, sir.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you.